of the Lord. At the outset, happy feast of Easter to all of you. Happy Easter to all of you. I was not expecting this reply because some would have wondered why Easter today. It was last Sunday. Well, all of us are aware that Easter is not limited to just one day. It is at least 1 week. And the church knows that this is a prototype of all Christian feasts and it cannot be limited to just one day. So it's an octave that we are in, which will conclude tomorrow, which is called the Sunday of Divine Mercy, actually. From the year 2000 onwards, we call this Sunday, the second Sunday in the season of Easter, as the Sunday of Divine Mercy. Pope John Paul II, in the year 2000, on April 30th to be precise, canonized somebody called Saint Faustina, who was actually his own country woman from Poland. And then that day he announced that from now onwards, every year, the second Sunday of Easter season will be termed as the Sunday of Divine Mercy. Well, if you have listened to the Gospel reading, I would like to focus on the first part of the Gospel, because the whole Gospel was pretty long, and if we go on explaining everything that is happening in today's reading, it will take pretty long time for us to explain and reflect upon. So I would like to focus on the first part, wherein Jesus appears to his disciples saying, "Peace be with you." That's what he says to everybody at any time after his resurrection. Whenever he met his disciples or whenever he appeared to others, he first said, "Peace be with you." And then he actually makes a threefold action. The first one is that he is commissioning his disciples. He is sending them out. And he says, "As the Father sent me, so am I sending you." Yes, all of us as disciples of Jesus are sent out into the world to proclaim to the world the gospel values that we have experienced. The second thing that Jesus does is he breathes on his disciples and says, "Receive the Holy Spirit." Therefore, what is the significance of that? If you are believing in the risen Jesus, you are automatically and simultaneously receiving the gifts of the Holy Spirit. So the resurrection and Pentecost are one and the same reality, at least according to St. John's Gospel. And the third thing that he does is that he institutes the sacrament of reconciliation. So today we are commemorating the institution of the sacrament of reconciliation when we are actually celebrating the Sunday of the Divine Mercy. Why? Because he says, if you forgive anyone's sins, they are forgiven. If you retain anyone's sins, they are retained. Sending the disciples 2 by 2, this is what he tells them. Look, go and forgive the sins of people. If you are forgiving them, they will be forgiven. And if you retain some sins, they will be retained. He is giving them authority. His disciples are given the authority to forgive in God's name. Only God can forgive. Only Jesus can forgive, as he is God. And as anointed disciples of Jesus, as representatives of Jesus, we priests have inherited an authority to forgive the sins of the faithful who come to us in the sacrament of reconciliation. So as I said, this is called the Sunday of Divine Mercy. Therefore, what is mercy? We can see mercy from two perspectives, negatively and positively. Negatively, it is not getting the punishment that I deserve to get. If I have committed some offense and I am not getting the punishment that I actually deserve, that is on account of the mercy of God. And the second thing, positively putting as put positively, is that I am receiving something which I don't deserve. I am receiving gifts, I am receiving compassion, I am receiving the benevolent mercy of God. So the mercy of God is precisely this. I would like to just bring to you a couple of illustrations only to explain what is actually mercy and compassion. One of the most moving stories that we have heard, at least back in India when I was there, is what happened on October 6, 2006, when an armed man entered an Amish school's house in Nickel Mines in Pennsylvania, and there he actually chased the little boys out of the classroom and made the small little girl children line up in front of the blackboard and shot all of them, all the 10 of them. 5 of them died on the spot, and then he killed himself. Now, when this story reached the parents and dear ones of these little kids who were dead, they carried the dead bodies back home, washed their wounds, and kept the bodies there and mourned for a while. And before they buried their bodies, they also buried their anger. How did they do that? They walked to the house of the young man who killed these children and met the wife of this young man, who was now obviously a widow, consoled her, sympathized with her, and told her that they forgave her husband. Now, this is what is divine mercy is all about. These people realized in a real sense that God's forgiveness of themselves depends on their extending forgiveness to other persons. If you have experienced mercy, you got to share it with other persons. Or let us put it the other way about, if you want to experience God's mercy and compassion, you got to be forgiving to one another. The second illustration is one that appeared in a Reader's Digest by a certain author, Jim Williams of Montana, who wrote like this: I was driving too fast that night, and when I saw the flashing light of the police car chasing me, I pulled over and rolled down my window of my station wagon, and I tried to figure out what excuse I could give to the cops who would come to ask me now. But the policeman came near my car. Instead, he merely shined his flashlight. He did not ask me anything. On my face, he flashed his light, and then next he flashed the light on my 7-month-old child who was in his car seat, and then the other 3 children who were sleeping, and then back of my car where there were 2 dogs, and finally he flashed his light on my face and said, "My dear son, look, you can't afford a ticket. You can't afford a ticket. Drive slowly." So saying, he went back to his car and drove away. Now, sometimes mercy triumphs over laws. We are so very often so legalistic in our approach. When there is a slight misunderstanding between the husband and wife, there is a whole lot of legal things coming across to us, and we want justice to be done. Here is communicating to us an instance where mercy and compassion goes beyond all legal dimensions. God's mercy is for sinners who call out to Him. Well, if you have seen the picture of divine mercy, Jesus, do we have the picture of Jesus' divine mercy? I have seen somewhere. Yes, it is there. So look at the picture. The picture has got 2 streams of light flowing from His side, Jesus' side. We are told in the Gospel that when the soldier pierced Him with a lance, the blood and water flowed from His side. And those two streams, which are white and red in color, they are actually symbolizing the blood and water that flowed from the side of Jesus, which is actually the foundation for our baptismal commitment, by which we are enjoying the mercy of God. Finally, let me just bring to you the kind of questions that we ask ourselves. Why should I make my confession? Why should I go for a sacrament of reconciliation? Why should I go to a priest, etc.? These are some of the questions that we ask ourselves. But remember, it is God who forgives our sins. Therefore, if we know that, is it not enough to approach God directly and ask for forgiveness? Yes, surely it is enough. But then what is the guarantee? Is there a visible sign that our sins are forgiven? That is received when we are opening up to another individual whom the community has anointed and appointed as a representative of all of us. Therefore, we are asking forgiveness in the name of personally, we ask forgiveness from that person to ask for, to bless us and pardon us in the name of God. So let us, as we continue with this Eucharist, remember on this Divine Mercy Sunday that first and foremost we experience God's divine mercy in manifold ways, and let us ask for the grace and courage and strength to share that mercy and happiness and forgiveness with one another. Secondly, also to approach the sacrament of reconciliation more frequently if needed than it is now. Amen.